Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Microsoft Security Update Summary, where I will present a short synopsis of what was released today, December 10th, 2024. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. I'm going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then I'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities that I'm covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to see how it stacks up. Today's release has 71 newly disclosed CVEs, and that's down from our average of just over 82 vulnerabilities per month. Within that set of 71 newly disclosed CVEs, 31 of those fall into the remote code execution impact. Remote code execution is the type of impact that typically provides the most risk. It would allow a threat actor to install software, another nefarious deed. Next, I'll talk to scoring, where Microsoft uses the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scale between 0 and 10, where 10 represents the highest level of risk. This month, the highest scored CVE comes in at 9.8 on that scale of 10. If we look at the average CVSS score across all 71 newly disclosed CVEs, our average comes out to 7.48, which is just a little bit below our average of 7.54. Next, we've been averaging just over 1.5 publicly disclosed vulnerabilities. This month we have one. These are the type of vulnerabilities where in some way or another, the vulnerability itself was disclosed, whether that was a Finder blog or maybe just a short post on social media. It might be with proof of concept or without. One way or another, this was made public, and this month there's just one of these in today's set. And finally, out of the vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited, there was one in today's set. We've been averaging just under 2 per month, about 1.8 there for the past 13 months. These are vulnerabilities that in one way or another, Microsoft or our partners have discovered that it's being exploited prior to release. We'll talk about this one in just a few moments. Okay, so we've taken a look at how this release stacks up to the previous 12 months. Let's dig into this release, and we'll start with the overview chart, where we put the Windows products towards the bottom of the chart, and then we move up into products that are not necessarily serviced every single month. That's certainly the case this month. With the Windows products, we've been averaging mid to high 40s, depending on the specific operating system. And as we can see in this chart, we have some products that are above average, some are below average, just depending on the exact Windows product that we're looking at. Then we move into Office, which has a handful of vulnerabilities this month, as well as SharePoint. System Center Operations Manager has a published CVE, and then Defender for Android to round out the overview chart. Okay, let's take a look at the first CVE that I'll talk to today, and this is CVE 2024-49138. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability in the Common Log File System, or CLFS. This has a base score of 7.8 on that scale of 10, but we do have publicly disclosed and the exploitation detected flags on this vulnerability. So this one vulnerability hits both publicly disclosed and known to be exploited out in the wild. It's the only one in the set that has either one of those flags. The attack vector is local, the attack complexity is low, low privileges are required, but no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. As far as the affected software, it's Server 2016, 2019, and 2022, as well as Windows 10 and 11. Next, I'll talk to a vulnerability in LDAP. This is CVE 2024-49112. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in the Lightweight Directory Access Protocol, or LDAP. This was privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 9.8, so this hits the high watermark of the scoring in this month's release. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges required, and no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There is a mitigation for this, which is that we recommend that domain controllers are configured to either not access the internet or to not allow inbound RPCs from untrusted networks. Either one of these would work, but we recommend applying both of these for domain controllers. And again, mitigations are intended to be a short-term action that can protect a vulnerable server until that server can be updated with the cumulative update. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in support, whether that's Windows 10 or 11 on desktop, or Server 2016, 2019, 2022, or 2025 on the server side. And the third vulnerability that I will talk to is CVE-2024-49117. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in Hyper-V. This one was privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 8.8. The attack vector is local. The attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required here, but no user interaction is required. A threat actor who is able to leverage this vulnerability would be able to gain VM to host remote code execution. So threat actor could be on a virtual machine and be able to attack the host or other VMs that are on that host. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability, and to protect your environment, your systems from this vulnerability, you would need to install the cumulative update. As far as the affected software, it's Windows 11, Server 22, and Server 2025. Some of the other versions of Windows are not affected here, are not in play. If you are a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer, and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your Customer Success Account Manager, or CSAM, to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub. Okay, that's all I have for today. I want to thank everyone for joining, and I will talk to you all next month.